we're looking to maximise the efficiency and the efficacy with applications with 2,4-D, it all begins here with the nozzle, making sure that we've chosen a nozzle can meet the label requirements or permit requirements for a very coarse spray quality or greater, and making sure that that actually matches the travel speed that we're doing and being aware of the pressure that's required to operate those nozzles. We also need to take into account the boom height. Now, the height above the target or the ground is specified on the label, so making sure that boom height is set at the right spot is absolutely critical. Once we've got that right, we need to think about what's going on back at the tank. So in other words, the application volume we've chosen may actually be higher than what we've used in the past. So there's a number of things we should consider before mixing up and going and spraying. If you're using increased application volumes, there's a lot of things to consider, particularly water quality. Using more water means that if there's any problems with it, you're more likely to have a problem with the product or an interaction. So if you're going to increase water volume, get your water quality tested and make sure that it's suitable for the job. The second thing about the tank is it's best not to use products that increase drift over summer, such as your non-ionic wetters, but there are a range of products that can increase efficacy and manage droplet size. So when you're putting more water in the tank, yes, it would mean more water conditioners, and it probably means more adjuvants. So take that into account in your overall cost of application as well, but in your planning for how you handle logistics. And if you're operating with coarser nozzles and you change to a higher pressure air induction, don't forget to go to the controller settings and check and rechange those minimum settings. Usually they'll operate at a minimum of 3 bar if they're high pressure air inductions. The number of mixing and filling operations required will increase if you increase the application volume. So it's really important to consider ways to maintain the efficiency in the paddock. So faster fill operations means the ability to hook up to the sprayer, hopefully without folding up the boom. So the further forward this fill point is, the better. Obviously a front mounted one would make that even more efficient. The other thing to consider is things like mixing plants and batching plants and having water tankers at the paddock. Anything that minimises your time out of the paddock is going to increase efficacy by allowing you to finish the job in a shorter period of time. And don't forget that if you're increasing the water volume and you are adding things to improve water quality like ammonium sulphate, allow plenty of time for those things to dissolve to make sure that the load is going to be as efficacious as possible. Many spray operators may be concerned about using larger droplets, particularly the very coarse, extremely coarse spray qualities, because they haven't had experience with them before. But there's many people that have sprayed with these for a long time around the country, and they've had great success in summer fallow with fully translocated products. The key is to obviously selecting the nozzle and operating at appropriate pressure, making sure that water volume matches the target, often 70 litres for very coarse or 80 litres or more with an extremely coarse. Get the boom height right and make sure that you're putting the right things in the tank. So treating the water if you're using more water volume and getting those mixing and filling operations correct. And if you get all those things right, you can get really good results, particularly over summer. And if you want more information, make sure you see the other videos in this series.